Right, folks, in this video, we're going to be looking at this guy here. It's the KAM GM25 Special Edition Mixer. Now, it's small and sweet, but it packs a punch. Right, there you go. I'll just hold the camera tight. Move that so I can see what I'm doing. There's a little screen there. Right, first of all, there's my hand, and there's a CD, so it'll give you a rough idea of the actual size. It's pretty petite, but it does its job. Okay, what have we got here? We've got an interchangeable crossfade. Now, one beauty about this particular interchangeable crossfade is, guess what? When you've knackered it, you haven't got to think, oh dear, it's broken, I better phone up and order another one, because it comes with a spare one. That comes in the box, so for goodness sake, don't lose it. Put it somewhere safe. Okay, features. Two channels, two sliders, but guess what? It's actually a seven-channel mixer. I know you're scratching your head now, but I'll explain that very shortly. All right, what we've got here is Q level. Basically, when the Q level is set to 7 o'clock, you won't hear any music at all through your headphones. As you increase the Q level up to 5 o'clock, you'll get the full amount. But bearing in mind, just be careful of your ears. Q assign, what that will do, let's have this sort of scenario. Let's say channel 2 is blasting through the PA system, your crossfade's over, channel 1 is set to 0, so you can't hear anything through the actual PA system because this level is down. Now what happens here, we press the Q button in, when that's depressed in, it means we can hear through the headphones this channel, but we will not hear anything through this channel through the headphones. As we turn the Q assign clockwise from 7 o'clock through to 12, through to 5, we will start to not only hear this channel, but we will also be able to hear the channel being played through the main headphones. That's basically what the Q assign will do. Alright, we've got a mic gain, in other words, when the same as your Q assign and the same as the Q level. When the mic gain is set to 7 o'clock, nothing will come through the microphone. You won't get any sound at all. As you move this particular dial through 12 o'clock, etc., 1 o'clock, the volume will increase on your microphone. But be wary, do not start wanging it up, because if your PA is really loud, all of a sudden, if you turn it up too high, you could get lots of whistles and funny noises through your speakers. Okay, above that, we've got your master level. Basically, that will increase the main output from this particular mixer. Okay, hold tight, we'll just turn it around. Actually, before we turn it around, I'll just show you here. Two inputs, there's your microphone input, and there's your headphone input. Alright, if we look at the back of it now, I said it was seven channels, so if I put that like that. Okay, what we've got here is this first connection for your RCA cables. This will do a line input and a phono input. Your line, logically, is your, say, your MP3 player, your CDJ, or maybe a DVD player even, maybe even a DAT player. You need to set the button there to line. So this button here, set to line. Now this channel here will work line. If you switch that over to phono, now this channel here, the first one, will only work for a vinyl turntable. The second channel is just line. The third channel is exactly the same as the first channel. Cross here, and this channel here will work a vinyl turntable. Switch it over, now this one will work a CDJ. The fourth channel will just work your CDJ, your line input. Record output here, basically what you can do here is you can go into, say, an actual recording unit. You can plug this in maybe to your laptop and record your set. And then this here is basically for your main output into your amplifier. You've got an on-off button. This here, very important, a lot of people always ask me, they say, you know, I'm always having buzzing sounds from my vinyl turntable. Well, it's because you need to ground it. So that is there for one reason. Your little thin wire coming from your vinyl turntable has to go in here, tighten that up, and it will stop it buzzing. That is basically your power input. So there you go. A quick idea of what that guy can do. It's the KAM GM25 Special Edition 7-channel mixer. And it's small, petite, but it does the job. Practice and enjoy.